Hello friends, in this video let's talk about one of the important and easy concept in SQL Server. The concept is dynamic SQL. It is easy and important for all the SQL developers. So what is dynamic? See, it is a self-explanatory word. Dynamic SQL, it prepares the SQL query dynamically. It means that the query is not ready at the starting point. It prepares dynamically at runtime. At a particular point of time, the final query will be one, and at later point of time, the query might change because of the dynamic. It prepares dynamic. So based on the dynamic query, results will come. Then how to write a dynamic query in SQL Server, and what is the advantage and what is the disadvantage, I'll show you. If you know that your final result always, if you do not need to handle multiple scenarios, and if you know that the query is static, then you might not require to touch dynamic SQL. If you do not know the final query, then you may need to go for a dynamic SQL. So before going to talk about practically advantages and the background, not only this concept, if you have any questions in SQL Server, MSBI, Azure and Power BI, please drop your question in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. And also follow me on Facebook for more technical updates. Subscribe on YouTube for more technical videos. So let's move on to the SQL Server. So I have SQL Server 2016. I will be showing you all my examples in SQL Server 2016 window. But dynamic SQL concept is not new in 2016. We have in 2008, 2012, 2005 and all. So let me show you one basic table which I use for my examples. So I have a very basic table. So the name of the table is fact sales. So I created a basic table. So to show you a couple of examples. So I might use this table for some more examples. Now, so let me write one more query to get how many rows on it. Count of star or count of one from fact sales. So this will give me the list of rows. See, it looks like a very basic thing, but it's a very important example I'm going to show you. Select AVG of sales amount from fact sales. Yes, this is the average amount. Now let me write select from fact sales sum of sales amount. Okay, so now if you see this, the first query is all the records, there is no change. Let's not take that into the execution now. Let's run this. First one will give you the count of records, second one will give you the average, third one will give you the sum. So let me make it as here alias names to understand. Let me make it as total average. So rather than execute, rather than keeping as a keywords, I kept it as a count. This is the average, this is a total. Okay, so this is a total. Now up to here, there is no dynamic SQL and all. I'm just preparing a scenario to explain you in a detailed manner. Yes, so now I will be passing a parameter to this query. Based on that value, I want to calculate either count or average or sum. It depends on my input. It considers, it takes my input. My query has to execute based on the user input. My query has to execute based on my input. I am the user to the SQL Server. So let me prepare, let me convert this basic query into the required scenario. So I'm just showing you from the starting point here so that you can also prepare in an easier way. You can also practice in the easier way. So let me declare one variable. Declare decision. Decision where care of 1. Assume it. Okay, equal to by default is empty. Next, declare dynamic query. I'm just giving a name of the variable var char of max. I'll tell you why I'm taking as a max. By default, I'm taking as empty. Now, set decision equal to C assume. So if I pass C, I should get the count. If I pass A, I should get the average. If I pass S, I should get the sum. That's how I'm going to prepare the query. Now, if decision equal to C, next begin count end, else if decision equal to A begin end else begin. I'm just adding the begins to understand in a better way, otherwise you may not require these many begins. So if you see all these queries on a single table, so one is giving the count, one is giving the average, the other one, last one, is giving the sum. Okay, now see, I declared a variable. Let me remove this variable. I don't need it. I'll explain you. Wait. Now I just created one basic variable decision, varchar equal to 1, decision equal to C. I just passing C. Then if decision is C, I want the count. If decision is A, I want the average. If decision is S, I want the sales amount. For the first scenario, I am taking as a C. Let me run this query. Let me see what is happening. Yeah, okay. Now the total, if I pass C, it is giving the value as 16. Because it is getting executed. So let me pass this as a. Let's run this. If I pass as a, I will be getting average. If you really see this, I am getting average. So if I pass yes, because I have made it as any other condition, if I pass a, other than a and c, I will get the sum only, because I made it as simple else condition. There is no if here. Let's run this. Now 93,800. Now let's make it as some x r AS or something like that. If you pass it, still I'll get 93,800 only. Why? Because I made it as a else part. Irrespective of A and C, whatever the value you pass, you'll get a total sum only, because I don't have if condition. Now, if you see, on the whole, if you really understand as a developer, so you will be duplicating similar query in multiple times. Same query, simply only this is changing, this is getting changed. Other than this, everything is same. Then how to make it dynamic? How to make it a dynamic? So let's keep this as it is. Let me open a separate window here. So let me take like these two variables. Okay, let me make it as C for time being. So let me declare one more variable which I declared earlier and removed. Yet dynamic. You can create whatever the variable you want. It's not something I am creating dynamic variable, dynamic SQL variable name. You can keep whatever the name you want. Next, dynamic SQL. So now what I am doing is, if decision equal to C, what I am trying to do is, let me declare one more variable for easy understanding. Declare yet function. What function you want to do it? Varchar of some 50. equal to empty. Now if decision equal to C begin, see why I am using begin is for easy understanding. You may not require these many begin and ends. Begin this function set. Set function equal to count of, see please try to understand in a better way, count of star count. Next, else if decision equal to A, like earlier second condition is A. Now let's come here, if decision equal to A, now again begin end, now set yet function equal to average. Now AVG of sales amount space AVGE, I made it as, okay, else I am making as a else, there is no other condition, all else will come into here only, okay. So now set yet function equal to sum of sales amount space total. See, if you understand clearly what I made it as, whatever this one which is happening, I made it as a dynamic. Now I'm doing, now I'm capturing this only. Now once it is done, I'm going to prepare a query. How to prepare a query is set. Now real dynamic SQL comes into the picture. This is a place where we form a dynamic query, set. So what is the name of the variable? As dynamic SQL. So now why I made it as max? Because I'm not sure how much big query I'm going to get it at the end. If I keep it as varchar 20, varchar 50, varchar 100, my query may not fit in the particular size. That is the reason why I made it as varchar max. Now let's come back to the point. Set dynamic SQL equal to, so ideally what query has to run? Select and function and from sales. Now I am going to write it select space and plus this function, whatever the function you are planning to keep, plus is the concatenation operator in SQL, and from fact sales. Now see, my query is ready. So now dynamically, because till now I do not know what kind of query I am executing here, so it automatically identifies during the execution itself. So do you want to see the query, what query my SQL engine is preparing at the end? Yes, you can see by using print dynamic SQL. Later once it is printed, then I'll execute it, I'll show you the later. Now first, if you really see here, I will be passing C as a decision, then I should be getting the count query. Let's run this. So once you run this, do you see this is the query, you got it as the output. Now if you really understand here, the query, this and this is both are same, I'm keeping here. Do you see this query and this query are the same? Then next I'll show you the results, but let's see here, I'm going to pass A. Ideally if I pass A, what query I should get it is this one. I should get this average query. Let me run this. Yes, in the print you can see this, select average sales amount AVGE from fact sales. Let's pass, apart from A and C, let's pass some, yes. Now let's run this, I should get a sum query. Now you can see this. Now how to execute it? Yes, we are right, we got the correct query only. Then how to execute it? How to execute the dynamic queries? So let's use execute function, execute of, keep this query, whatever the final query you have in your hand, let's put that query here. So once you keep it, it will execute this and it will show you the final result. If you really see here, I will be passing yes. When I pass yes, I should get the sum, right? I should get the sum here, because it's a else part. Let me run this query. Let me see the spelling is correct or not for this. Sales amount Let me make it as yes. Let me see what's wrong here. Maybe column name might be wrong here. Okay, spelling is wrong. I need to put ENT. Where is that? UNT. N is missing here. Yes, now let's run this. Yes, do you see this? Total, and the query is this. Total is 93,800. So now let me make it as C or A here, just to see the count or A, let's say. Yes, it's correct only. Now let us see, the average is this. Now you can see the dynamic query, the query which has been prepared during the execution. So because I am also not sure what query my SQL engine is going to execute it. It prepared during the runtime and it is executed and it has given the results. So based on the input. So this is what is called as a dynamic SQL. That's it about a dynamic SQL introduction. In the next video, I will talk about how to use dynamic SQL in stored procedures. Thank you for watching. If you have any questions, please drop your question in the comment section. I'll try to answer as soon as possible. And also follow me on Facebook for more technical updates. Please like and subscribe for more technical videos. Thank you.